Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel. We are back with a new video. If you like our content, please like the video and do share it. So let us start with the first news. Russian President Vladimir Putin will be the president of Russia for another 16 years, that is till 2036. This decision came after the Russian government made changes to their constitution and made some constitutional reforms. And these constitutional reforms were gone through a nationwide referendum. In this referendum, the Russian people were allowed to vote by saying a yes or no to the referendum. The nationwide referendum was conducted to approve the constitutional reforms made by the Russian government. Among these reforms, there was one change which made the Russian President Vladimir Putin the President of Russia for 16 more years. The constitutional reforms include many more changes besides the change that the President's term shall exceed by 2 terms. Some of the other constitutional reforms include banning the same-sex marriages in Russia, some pension relief measures, and shaping responsible attitude towards animals, and many more changes. During the referendum, 64% of the Russians voted for the referendum, and among this 64%, 70% of the people were in favor that Putin should be the president of Russia for 16 more years. Talking about the history of Vladimir Putin, Putin had been the president 2000. Yes, Vladimir Putin first fought his election for the presidentship in 2000, and since then he has been either the president or the prime minister of Russia. And now Vladimir Putin will be the president of Russia till 2036, which will make him the most serving president of Russia after Stalin. Coming on towards the next news, My GOV Corona Help Desk, which is a government chatbot, has received 2 awards in the COGS 2020 Artificial Intelligence Summit. The 2 awards are People's Choice COVID-19 Overall Winner and the second one Best Innovation for COVID-19 Society. Here there are 2 terms, MyGOV Corona Help Desk and COGS 2020. Let us understand both in detail. First, COGS 2020. This is one of the world's largest event on artificial intelligence. It is held annually in London with over 15,000 participants in attendance. And during this summit in London this year, My GOV Corona Help Desk, which is made by the Government of India with the help of JioHaptik and WhatsApp team, bags 2 awards in the Artificial Intelligence Seminar. Now, what is MyGOV Corona Help Desk chatbot? It is world's largest citizen engagement platform that is responsible for two-way communication between the citizens of the country and the government. In response of the outbreak, the chatbot received more than 76 million messages and it has processed over 41 million conversations. So, this chatbot gives the citizens of country information regarding their queries. And if you are in India and you want any information regarding Corona, you can dial the number shown in the screen. Every year, July 2 is celebrated as the World Sports Journalist Day, or it can be termed as International Sports Journalist Day. This day is celebrated so to acknowledge the sports journalist and also mark the anniversary of International Sports Press Association, AIPS. The International Sports Press Association was established in 1924 during the Summer Olympics in Paris. So, to mark its anniversary, the World Sports Journalist Day is celebrated. Many sports person and their fans celebrated this day by sharing the pictures of the sports journalist they came in contact with. The sports journalists are those people who bring the sports news and the news related to other sports persons to their fans. Recently, the presidential candidate of the Democratic Party, Joe Biden, has said that he will be removing the suspension of US work visa if he is elected to be the president of United States. So let us get into the detail of the suspension of US work visas. The US government has temporarily suspended the green cards and the non-migrant working visas till 31st December 2020. Earlier during this year, due to the coronavirus pandemic, from March itself, the non-migrant working visas were suspended and it further are suspended till 31st December. The US government has decided to suspend the work visas because there is a rising unemployment in the United States due to the coronavirus pandemic. The suspended work visas include H-1B visa, H-4 for some H-1B spouses, H-2B visa, L-1 visa for intra-company transfers, J visa for educational and cultural workers. Among this, the H-1B visa is the most popular non-immigrant visa. And to obtain H-1B visa, you must have an offer of employment from a US employer. Yearly, 85,000 H-1B visas are given to the non-immigrant workers. Second, the H-2B visas are given to the foreign workers who come temporarily to United States to perform some non-agricultural service or labor. Third, the L-1 visa. The L-1 non-immigrant visa is for the employees who work for a foreign company that is an affiliate of a US company, or L-1 employees are transferred from the foreign company branch to the US company branch. And the last one are the J visas, which are for the educational and cultural workers. These visas are being suspended till the end of the year. Moving on towards our last news. Recently, China has passed a national security law in Hong Kong. After the details of the bill was revealed, the whole world reacted to the national security law passed in Hong Kong. Each and every country condemned the actions of China by passing the security law in Hong Kong, including countries like Australia, United States, European Union, and many other countries. Following the national security law, the British government has offered citizenship to the Hong Kong residents. The UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson said in the Parliament that the law was a violation of Hong Kongers' freedom, and in response, the UK would offer all British national overseas passport holders and their dependents the right to remain in UK, including the right to work and study for 5 years. He also added that passing the national security law was a breach of the joint declaration that was signed between China and the British Empire in 1984. In response to this, the China has warned United Kingdom's decision to offer the citizenship to the Hong Kong residents, saying that it was the matter of a semi-autonomous Chinese territory. Now, is there a violation of the joint declaration that was signed by the British Prime Minister Margaret Thatcher and Chinese government in 1984? What were the conditions of the joint declaration then? The conditions included the preservation of region's high level of autonomy from mainland China and the additional rights and freedom of its citizens. It was also agreed in the declaration that Hong Kong's capital system, which was different to China's communist model, would continue. That means a theory of one nation, two systems. After passing this law, there was a havoc in Hong Kong's streets. The people came in the street and protested against the Chinese government. More than 300 people were arrested on the first day after which the national security law was passed amid the protests. So, this is it for today. If you like this video, subscribe to our channel to get the regular updates from our channel.